It's hot in here today, Jazz.
Yeah, the weather's lovely, isn't it? It helps. Don't need to say anything, make them wait and stuff like that. It helps a lot, like.
And you're going to wear a sweatsuit as well.
Yeah.
I don't think there'll be any problems with the weight. This fight, Jazz, there's been a big change in it. You're supposed to be fighting Tommy Ward, who took the title from you.
Yeah.
But now you're going to be fighting his brother Martin, who you've actually met before as well. So, you know, when did the change, when did you hear about it, and how you took it?
From the start, I didn't expect Tommy to fight in the business title against me anyway. It's been like over a year now. As soon as we got out of the ring after the last time, because it ended so controversially, we wanted the rematch right away, and he went too keen on the rematch, so I knew that he didn't want to fight, and he'd do anything to get out of the fight, whether that meant get a voluntary opponent or whatever. So coming up to this fight, it's been put off. It's been like over a year I've been trying to get it back now. So I didn't expect it. It was after in the back of my mind, but I fought Martin before. I know Martin's got big balls, and I know that he's definitely going to fight. So what he's done, he pulled out 2 days before the required time, the length of time you're about to pull out, and put Martin in there faster. It's good management on their behalf. But for me, not changes really. It's the same night, same venue, same place, same people are going to be there. My fans, his fans, so same thing for me. I'm just going to, obviously, my strategy a little bit, but other than that, then getting a bit title back.
Well, you've been with Martin before, and it was a toe to toe battle. Do you expect it to be the same kind of fight?
Really, because I fight the way I fight, and he fights the way he fights. I don't think no one's going to be tuning in. Too fancy, kind of, thinking nothing new. I think we're going to fight the way we both fight. I know the way he fights, you know the way I fight. So, I think it will be similar to last time. Only that I'm a little bit younger, he's a little bit older. I'm a bit more in my prime and a bit more stronger. That's how I see going in there, a little bit more fit too. A bit more wiser. I fought for the world title since. Before we fought the first time, he was the only one who had fought for the world title. But now, I've fought for the world title, I've been top of the game, and know the game works. I've had a few more 12 round fights, so I feel a lot more confident going in this time too.
And Tommy's on the undercard, he's fighting for like an international title, so it's a fight that will probably be made at some point down the line that anyway, so do you see that yourself?
I doubt he will. I've got a bit of a problem just getting fights. The same happened a few years ago with Gavin McDonald. I was mandatory for his British title, and he vacated, signed contracts to fight, he vacated, and then I got myself mandatory again for the European, as he vacated the British one, the European, done the same thing to me then, signed contracts 6 weeks into his training camp, and he vacated again. So I've had a problem, I've been getting opponents. I would say that I've got a few losses on my record. I might risk not necessarily high rewards, and I get that from a business point of view. So if we do fight again, it'll only be at the very top.
Yeah. Well, your dad Collins here next to us, bring you in, Pop. You say that last fight with Martin Ward, it was a brilliant fight. You was there ringside, and it was never filmed apparently. But it was a real scrap.
It was like probably one of the best fights I've seen. It was a real scrap. Yeah. I had the privilege of carrying the belt into the ring, the title belt into the ring. It was lovely to do. Yeah, it was an amazing scrap. I think what's lovely about where Jazz's boxing now, this place used to be our youth club when I was a kid. It's where this ring is. I used to play snooker here, and Jazza did. So this has like come full circle. There's a school underneath. I went to the school, so did Jazza. And here we are now with this little fella in this ring where I went to school. He did, and hopefully he'll go to the same school but still underneath. So it's like come full circle for you if you like with Jazza. Like the bit of sadness he's had in a few fights, and he's persevered. And now our house is literally there, right where we live. And and he's boxing in it. When you say your own backyard, he's boxing in his own house, if you like, yeah, where he grew up as a kid, which is, it's great.
Derry and Georgie Vaughan over here, you know, a great team, and you know, Derry's a lot of experience. And how do you see he's settled in just since he's been here?
Brilliant. I can remember years ago when what was said about you actually going with Georgie one day?
Yeah, it was coming out of this boxing. I think I had 7 fights, and Georgie and his son Danny was coming out the same venue.
At the Olympia, yeah.
No, the Dockers Club it was. And Georgie said, you'll be with us one day. And I was just a kid, and Georgie Vaughan. And we were walking out with him. We had just got fights at night, and it was like a massive compliment, you know, to me, for him to say something like that to me. And it's mad how the future's sort of come full circle.
There you are.
Yeah, and there he is, and Terry's in the ring holding the pads, and then he's got Georgie's wisdom, just like running the show is what to do, and running the programme. It's really nice, and it's encouraging. It's like Jazza's looking up to Georgie, like a father figure, someone he's respecting, someone. I mean, his last fight, which was great for Jazza, he's gone back to the corner after the first round. He said to Georgie, I'm actually feeling safer and better in size. So Georgie said to him, you're the fighter, lad, if you feel safer, carry on. Which was great, because it was proving for Jazza to stay in there, and he got the kids out in the fifth round. But he's got trust in Georgie, and Georgie's given him responsibility too. Which is like, it's a nice team, yeah.
Well, yeah, a bit now, Jazz, haven't you? So you've had time to bed in, and it's you're reaping the rewards of being here. You feel?
Yeah, definitely. Got a good warm up fight and ready for a bit of fighting. Last time we went up there, a story about my alpha, he carried the belt in, but he underestimated the
weight of it.
What it takes to carry a belt in. He comes down and the ring walks about, must have been about 5 minutes, so he starts it off with him and he's excited up here. Slowly he comes down and in the end he's standing there like that.
Like that on the ropes, fucking hell, let me get out of this ring.
Well, I'm sure you're bringing it back, you won't mind carrying it all the way back to Liverpool if you're going to win it.
I'll wear it, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Well, all the best, Jazz. We're obviously going to be catching up a little bit and see you training up today, and that's all the best in camp for this fight.
Thanks, Chris. Nice one.
Chris Cole.
Nice one, thank you.